Colonel Jessop, you want answers? Lieutenant Kaffee, I think I'm entitled to them. Colonel Jessop, you want answers? Lieutenant Kaffee, I want the truth. Colonel Jessop, you can't handle the truth. Here we are, deep into another general election, with everyone, it seems, in search of the elusive truth. Just as Lieutenant Kaffee was when questioning Colonel Jessop in A Few Good Men. This search for truth in politics is viable only in part. There are no facts, and there is no truth, about what the future holds. We, the people, simply have to rank the credibility of the assertions put before us. That's politics. But there is truth, and there are facts, in the present, and in the past. That goes for Brexit, which was supposed to be the single issue of this campaign. But it also goes for the issue which, as night follows day, inevitably emerges, the NHS. Not for the first time, it is the debate on the NHS that has provoked peak hysteria on all sides. It is, once again, the last chance to save the NHS. And once again, we are to save it from privatization, this time Donald Trump's variety. Truth in this debate is hard to find. Opinion poll after opinion poll after opinion poll tells us the NHS is Britain's national religion, so politicians have free rein to employ hyperbole liberally. Biggest scare story wins. But the NHS has its truths, and if we were able to handle them, we might create a decent national discourse. The central truth that would unlock the debate is that the NHS is not free. Our national conversation is conducted on a bizarre premise that we are so lucky in this country to have a free NHS. We've all seen the ubiquitous gush on our Facebook feed, "Last night I fell and hurt my arm and I went to A&E and they x-rayed me and it was broken and they put a plaster on and now I'm home having a cup of tea. I love our NHS." But what is missing from this narrative is the fact that the ostensibly lucky ducky sitting at home sipping a cup of tea with their good arm has paid for that privilege. Scotland's average salary is roughly £25,000, with the income tax payable being around £5,000 per year. The NHS receives, very conservatively, about one-third of Scottish government spending, so an average earner spends over £1,500 of their personal earnings on the NHS every year. And, of course, that does not include any of the other taxes they contribute to the government's pot. This is called health insurance. For that is what the NHS is, a national health insurance system. It is akin to all insurance systems, whereby we collectively pool our risk. There are differences, to be sure. Firstly, our health insurance has a compulsory provider. Secondly, we guarantee nobody is uninsured. And finally, instead of premiums based on risk, premiums are based on income. If you earn £50,000, you'll pay well over £3,000. For more on this story, visit the news article link.